how to smoothly zoom in and out on Premiere Pro. First up, let's go to Effects, type in Transform, and move the Transform effect to our clip. Now let's go to Effect Controls, find the Transform effect, and the first thing we need to change is the shutter angle. Set that to 360, which is the highest it can go. That will create the motion blur on the zoom. Then hit the stopwatches on Position and Scale, which creates two keyframes, which I'll move to the right so we can see them. Now bring the playhead to the keyframes, press Shift and the arrow key 4 times, which will move us 20 frames to the right. As long as the keyframes are selected, press Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V to copy and paste the keyframes in the new position. I'll just expand the view so we can see those clearer. This shows us the length of the zoom. The keyframes would also appear if you just adjusted the parameters without copying and pasting them. But in this case, now that I've got the keyframes, I'll change the values of the position and the scale to move the frame to the position that I want to zoom into. So there's our zooming effect. Before we make it smooth, let's create the zoom out effect. But we don't want it to zoom in and immediately zoom out. We want it to hold in the middle, so let's create that holding section. Copy the last set of keyframes we created, we'll move along a few frames and then we'll paste it in place. This will create a static part of the zoom where we're just holding it in the zoomed in position. And then we'll take the first set of keyframes and then we'll paste those at the end because that was our original state. I'm just going to make the holding section slightly bigger by grouping the zoom out keyframes and moving them to the right. When we play that back, that'll be a zoom in, hold and zoom out. Now to smooth out the movements, hit the arrows on the left hand side to open up the keyframes. Group the keyframes, right click any one of them, go down to temporal interpolation and then down to ease in. And right click the keyframes again, back down to temporal interpolation and this time go for ease out. That balances out the ease of the movement, which on playback you can see is now more organic and smooth. Next step is to save it as a preset. So go to Effect Controls, right click the transform effect, go to Save Preset, type in the name you want to call the preset, change the type to anchor to endpoint, press OK, and that's our preset saved. To demonstrate, I'm going to delete the effect on the clip, create an adjustment layer, add that to the sequence, and then we'll go to effects. We'll search for the preset we just made and drag that onto the adjustment layer. Now let's play that back. That's working as it should. Of course, the zoomed in position might not be perfect for every clip, but it's easy to adjust, so you do it like this. Throw a new clip on the sequence, we press Alt and drag to copy the adjustment layer over to the new clip. As you can see, the zoom is there, the scale is fine, but it doesn't zoom into where we need it on this particular clip. So if we just adjust the X and Y on the position on the second set of keyframes, and then I'll copy those onto the third set of keyframes. Those middle two sets of keyframes control where we zoom into and out of, so we now have a new position that we zoom into, we're good to go. Hope that helps, see ya.